In this video, I'm going to explain the difference between a title tag and alt text in WordPress. And WordPress has some nuances when it comes to this, and there is no 100% right answer because it's all up to interpretation. So make sure to watch the video till the end and I'll explain everything, how it works. And I promise to give you clear guidelines on how to apply those things on your website as well. So what is the alt text? Alt text stands for alternative text, which means that if your image is for some reason is broken, the alt text is what shows up on the screen. So here example, I deliberately created a broken image on the site, and in this case you can see on the WordPress website that the alt text is being utilized to show on the screen. Now this is also used for accessibility. So if let's say a visually impaired user is visiting your website using a screen reader, then the alt text can be read by a text reader on the screen so that user can understand what's going on. But sometimes the title can also be utilized. So it's not 100% a thing that only the alt text will be used. Sometimes the title is also used. Now, what is the title? Visually speaking, the title is something that looks like this. Now, I know you don't see anything on the screen here, but if I hover over the image, you'll see a tooltip instantly pop up on the screen. Now, this is coming from the title of the post. Now, when it comes to significance of adding image text and alt text, technically you should add both, but it's generally accepted that the SEO benefit of adding alt text to your images is higher than adding image titles. So when it comes to prioritizing your efforts in adding something, either the image, say title or the alt text should get a little higher priority. But I'll tell you an easy way to manage all of this on your website automatically at the end of this video. Now, WordPress handles alt text and titles a little differently. So I'll have to explain to you how it works by showing you how the process works, and then I'll give you a good understanding of how to actually add and think about what should go inside the title and alt text. So I'll go to the media library here on my website. I'll just disable this and I'll add a new image on the site. All right, I'll just do this. Let's drag and drop it here. Now, if I click on this, you'll see that it has alt text, it has title, caption, description, file URL, all those details. And the title is being inherited from the image name itself. So if you have an image that has an appropriate name, and the title will be inherited automatically. So what I'll do is just, I'll do this. I'll say person typing on laptop keyboard. All right, so we'll fix the title here and we'll leave the alt text now. And if you just click outside, you'll see a save changes pop up somewhere. And you see it's saved, so it's done automatically. You don't need to click save and save it somewhere. Now we've added this image, we've added the title. Let's go to the post here, and what I'll do is I'll just create a new post and add new post. And now what I'll do is I'll just name this new test post. I'll add that image on the post. I'll add this image here, image, media library, this. Let's add it. You see the title here. Now, of course, the image doesn't have an alt text because we didn't add one. Let's publish the post. Let's publish the post. And this post is live. Let's open it in a new tab. And here. Now, since I've already added the title, that title should show up in the tooltip, right? But no, it doesn't. Because what WordPress uses the titles when it comes to the media library is used for identifying the images. It doesn't actually add the title there. So what you can do if you want to have that title appear on the image actually is go into the post settings here and then click on the image, which will open up the image settings, then go into the advanced options here, and then you can add the title attribute here. So if I do this and if I click this and I copy this because I'm lazy, I'll go here, I'll add the title attribute here, update, done. Let's open this post, refresh it, refreshed, and now the title shows up here. So that's how a little nuance with the title. But what about alt text? This is a funny story as well, and I'll explain why. So I'll go here and I'll click here, and now you see there's no alternate text. So I'll just write alternate text just to differentiate between the title and the alt text. So I'll just say alt text. Let's click update, and it's done. Now, if I go back to the media library, if I close this, I refresh this, you would think that the alt text applies to the image automatically, right? But no, the alt text doesn't apply. But the reverse is true. So let's try it one more time. What I'll do is, I'll do this. I'll add this image. I don't remember which image it is. All right, it's a different image. Let's add it here. Now I'll add laptop on desk. And saved. This is saved. We'll go back to the post here. And I'll just keep it here. I'll just add a new image. I'll search for image block. Let's add image. Media library here, And now you see the alt text here automatically. This, and now the alt text is here automatically. Why is this? There's actually a particular reason with this. Now, if I update this post, and you'll see, go back here, you see the title shows up here for this, and it also has an alt text. Now this has an alt text as well, which we can't see here, but the alt text exists. Now, this gives us a great understanding of how the alt text and title works in WordPress, and why WordPress treats the alt text when it adds to the media library, but not here. So let me explain. The title of an image usually is used to describe the image itself. So if I have an image here, for example, this image, I'm describing the image, what is the image about. But the alt text is very important to describe the image in the context of the post itself. So let's say, for example, if I was telling someone to, let's say the post is about how to reach a particular website, how to go to wbeginner.com. So the title of the image is fine, which says person typing on laptop keyboard. But in the context of the post, I might tell someone open their laptop and go to the browser and type wbeginner.com. And the alt text will be go and type wbeginner.com. And then I might just add some descriptive things here. Because think about this. If somebody is looking at the alt text as an alternative to screen readers, or as an alternative to a visually impaired person, or as an alternative to not actually having to being able to see the image here and read out the instructions, the alt text is mostly utilized for those purposes. So in that case, if the post is being read out and the image is also being read out, then it's easy for the person to understand what the context is. Now, this is not this is my interpretation of how the alt text and image title should be like. It's not a universally accepted guideline. So think about this as, I say, not with a grain of salt, but develop your own understanding around it. I wanted to just give out a clear differentiation between alt text and headlines, or say image titles, and how WordPress handles them differently. Now, you might think this is a lot of work to add so many titles and image alt text to all your images, and it is, so I have a great solution. What I do on my websites, and you should do so, or you should do as well, is just use All-in-One SEO. It's a fantastic plugin for SEO, and in the pro version, they have an awesome feature called Image SEO. By the way, there are tons of features here. So what this does is, if you install the Image SEO plugin or add-on from All-in-One SEO, you can just set templates for image titles and alt text attributes. So what I've done on my personal website as well, I've just installed All-in-One SEO Pro, I've activated the Pro add-on, and whenever I upload images, I just have templates set up for alt text and titles. So all of this headache, I would say, is taken care of automatically. I don't have to mess with this. I don't have to go around and change stuff. So once I've set it up, I just name the images appropriately before I upload, and rest everything just happens. I don't have to mess around with this. So if you have a busy website or busy life when it comes to building your website, then this is a great investment you should make, and it just solves your problem. And hopefully by this, you will also understand, or you should also understood, what's the difference between image title and an alt text. And if you still have questions and you want to just say thank you, the comment box is open. Otherwise, you can like this video, share this video, or subscribe to WBeginner for more WordPress education. My name is Viraj. You're watching WBeginner. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.